Welcome to another Demarcation Media Dust It Off video. So anybody who's collected toys will know that even though the companies make great products, there is usually a handful, if not more than a handful, of quality control issues that just don't seem to ever go away. And Mega is no different. They make some amazing products, but at the same time, they just have these little things that seem like they would be so easy to fix, but they can't seem to get past them. So there's a whole list of these quality control issues, and I would like to go through and kind of make some tutorials on how to fix these quality control issues. Now, there are some that you can't fix. So like, say you open a blind bag and you pull out your figure and you have a two right legs. I can't really tell you how to fix that. Or you open up a blind bag and you have one of the leg armors is a melted little mess. Can't really help with that either. But there are a handful of problems that I do know how to fix, and today we are going to be looking at how to fix one of them. So one of the biggest things, and this is not even necessarily a quality control issue per se, but loose joints. There is nothing more frustrating than getting a figure, getting him out of the box, and his arm just wants to flop around like it's broken, or the leg is all loose, you know, any number of things. The head is loose, and there's a really, really, really simple fix for that.
Glue.
So you're probably thinking, well, I'm just gonna glue the joint. No. So super glue can be used to basically increase the size of the joint that's loose. So we're actually gonna bring the camera in closer here because I have a couple examples, and I'm actually gonna show you how to actually apply the glue as well. All right, so here we are down on the desk, and I have three figures here. We have a Air Assault Spartan. This is from the Spartan 3 Customizer. We have the Garrison Pack Marine, and we have a, what is this, Mark 6 from Fireteam Crimson. Now, each of these guys has their own kind of problem. So this guy, he's got a loose waist. Look at this. There's like no friction here at all. So we're gonna have to fix that. The Marine, this guy isn't so bad, but his foot right here is a little loose. It's not as bad. Like some of the Marines I've seen in the past, the foot will literally spin around. But I've already fixed all those, so I don't have one for example. And this guy was, you know, close enough. And then the Crimson Spartan, he's got a really loose joint here. Like there's very little friction in both the elbow and the shoulder. So we're going to be fixing that as well. We'll work on the AA Spartan first. So we're just going to yank him in half, right? So this part of the Spartan can be put aside for now. We're going to remove the waist piece. I don't know. This gets a little iffy because basically what we're going to do is we're going to increase the size of the joint here. So it doesn't want to pop off as it is. So if we increase the size, then it's not gonna wanna pop off even more, or go back on, I should say. So we're just gonna do this here. So we're gonna open up our glue, and now you're gonna wanna have a safety pin on hand. The safety pin is what we're going to actually put the glue on first. So let's squeeze some glue out. I'm actually trying a different type of glue this time. I got the super glue gel instead of the normal super glue. Oh my word. Okay, that was not supposed to happen. Technical difficulties. Okay, so pro tip here, shake the super glue gel up before you use it. I didn't realize that it was separated. So yeah, it's not supposed to be that kind of liquidy. So I need to actually shake this up before I can use it. Now, if you just get normal super glue, you won't have to worry about this, but I'm just attempting to use the gel because supposedly it applies cleaner. Alrighty, so let's try this again. And we want just a little bit of glue at first. Come on, yeah, there we go. So we're just gonna kinda put it on the pin like this. Close up the glue. Now we're gonna take it here, and then we're gonna spread it on. We want it fairly even. Now, you want to kind of do this in thin layers at first. So right now what I just did, I'm going to let that dry for a bit. Wait, let me get the rest of the glue on there. Okay, I'm going to let that dry for a bit. So what we're going to do is it's going to dry, right? And it's going to get hard. And then we're going to pop it back into the Spartan's torso and see if it tightened up any. If it didn't, then we're going to do the process again and so on until the desired result is achieved. At this point, I'm sure you can kind of figure out how to do this for other parts of the figures on your own, but I'm just going to run through and do these guys anyway. Oh my goodness, come back. So we want to remove the foot like so, and we're literally just going to repeat the same process that we did with the AA Spartan. So we want a little bit of glue on the end. Don't need that much. We don't want overspill too. So that's what you got to be careful of, is when you're applying this, sometimes you'll get too much globbed up on the end of the pin, and then you're gonna have it spilling all over the place. And we really don't want that, because super glue, when it dries, it leaves like this white haze. So try to keep it confined to only the area that you want to tighten up. So there we go. Now that one needs to dry as well. So our last figure that needs some tightening up is the Crimson Spartan. Now this guy is a little more tricky, because the joints that are loose are actually closed up. So what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to disassemble the entire arm. So take the armor off, and then kind of work your fingernail under the edge of this little piece, and so you'll have this. Now the part that you want to thicken up here is the peg right here. And we need to repeat the process for the lower arm. Just kind of pop it out. Got to be a little careful when you're removing the pieces from the rubber sections, because if you dig your fingernail into it wrong, then it will dent it. Wait, I forgot. This guy's got the loose hand problem too. That's an entirely different issue, and that is one that we are going to talk about in a separate video. But I do have a fix for that as well. One that works most of the time. It's a little iffy sometimes. But at this point, you know what I'm gonna do. We're gonna get some glue. Wow, that's a little bit much, actually. So just make sure you have like a paper on hand or something while you're doing this. Just something to dab the excess glue on. Just kind of get it all in there. So, let that dry. Also, be careful not to glue these pieces to yourself, because I don't think any of you want to go around with a little Mega Construct joint glued to your finger for the rest of your life. So, just be careful. Yeah, come on. Same process. Just kind of spread it around on there. We don't get much on top, and boom, done. Now we just need to let that dry. Alrighty, here we are. I've left this guy drying for I think about an hour now. I would recommend you leave them at least for an hour, because the last thing you want to do is put the figure back together when the glue is even a slight bit wet, because obviously, you know, that's going to mean your figure is going to be a static figure instead of a poseable figure. So let's go ahead, pop this guy back together. Yeah, look at that. He actually has friction in his joint now. So that was a success. Let's test out our Garrison Pack Marine. Let's pop his foot back in there. I said, hello? That's another thing, is sometimes you may end up putting too much on, and that's not really a problem. You just have to shave some of it off. But this foot just doesn't want to go back in. Okay, so here's a good example, because it looks like we put too much on the foot.
So, let me see. I've got a file here. Maybe I can use that. Okay, so actually, I'm going to need an X-Acto knife. So, the thing here is all of the peg type joints have a peg and then a little like lip that sticks out. That's what keeps it in. It keeps it from falling back out again. And you don't want to shave that down. So I'm going to need a knife. I still have yet to find my normal X-Acto knife, which is kind of worrying, honestly. But I'm going to use this one instead. So what we're going to do is we're just going to shave a little bit off carefully. And as always, be cautious while using a knife. You don't want to cut yourself. I don't 100% know how much I need to take off. But basically, yeah, just take a little bit off. Try it again, take a little bit off, try it again until it fits on there. So I'm going to continue just shaving some of this. And then we'll put it back in the leg. Alright, I think I've got it. Ah, there we go. And it is a lot tighter than before. So let's go ahead and give the Marine back his leg, like so. Now the last bit is the arm for our Spartan here. So let's just go ahead and put these together. These small pieces are a bit fiddly to work with, but sometimes, you know, you just gotta do it. There's really no other way. Come on, okay, there we go. All right, it didn't tighten it a ton, but I think it was just enough. You see the white bits? That's a little bit of kind of what I was talking about, the haze that super glue gives off. That'll be hidden though, so it's not a problem. But dang, putting them back in is kind of difficult. Okay, that worked though. So let's put the entire arm together. That. Come on, it's sticking wrong. There we go. Perfect. And we will now pop it back into place. The elbow is a lot tighter now. I probably need to do another layer on the shoulder, but you know, you now understand the concept behind this fix. Well, there you have it. That is how to tighten up loose joints. Now, this will also work on pretty much any action figure where you can take the joints apart. So, Lego figures sometimes will have loose arms. You can do that to them as well. Pop the arm off, put a little glue on it, let it dry, put it back in. I don't recommend you do it to minifigures unless the arm is like really floppy. And you can also do this for like Gundams. So, if you have a Gundam, you put that the kit together and there's just some loose joints, just take it back apart, put some glue in the joint, let it dry, put it back together. It works kind of for some of the like Jazzwares figures. I've tightened up, I think it was parts of my Little Chief that way. But if you can't take the figure apart, that's an entirely different story. One that we're not going into right now because that doesn't apply for the Mega Constructs figures. So once again, literally all you need is
glue
and a safety pin, and then probably a paper or something to keep your glue from getting places that you don't want it to get. So hopefully this helps. Let me know how it works out for you guys, and I will see you guys in the next one.